I think I can handle that. I was here last night. You know.
Down and dirty garages where the restoration happens to pristine collections of well-known vehicles. Tailfins and Chrome shares the human interest side of automotive obsession. Fridays at 8 p.m. Grindhouse 614 Horizon 32. More at tbae.net.
You're listening to WMNF.
And you're listening to the live music showcase here on WMNF. I'm Bill Dudley, along with Steve Arduango and Mark Perfetti. We're in the control room today, and we've got a great live guest on. It's Rebekah Pulley doing a special solo swat here. I'm going to turn the mics up and say hi, Rebekah. How are you doing?
Hi there. Can you hear me?
Yeah, you sound great.
Oh, well, gosh, thanks.
That was
my best hello.
How about starting us off with a tune here? And you know, if you don't mind, tell us what each one is before you play it so that we'll know.
Sure. This is called Let It Shine. Let It Shine from a old recording from, my gosh, I think maybe 2007 or something. I wrote the song, I borrowed a little bit of the bridge from the old gospel hymn. So.
Start off with?
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hey, Rebekah Pulley's our guest on today's show. We're in the control room today because in a couple of weeks we're going to be moving into our new and improved live music showcase studio with a new control board and a whole bunch of other stuff. And it's all being updated, and they're in there wiring away. So we had to move back into the one of the control rooms here where we play records and stuff. Well, not records, but you know, in order to do the show today. So that's gonna, it's good, it sounds a little different, but we're happy to have Rebekah in with us today. And now you're gonna be appearing a bunch of places for WMNF in the days to come, right?
Well, tomorrow.
Is tomorrow Saturday?
I think it is.
Okay.
I think it is.
Tomorrow is the Little Manatee River Jam.
Beautiful downtown Waimea.
Yeah, it's at the Canoe Outpost, so it's there's camping, there's like nice little wooded areas to camp in. It's a great little stage.
Suburbs of Waimea.
Yeah. I've never actually been into the city of Waimea, so I don't know about that. I've just been to the Canoe Outpost, and it's really cool.
I've never been to the metro district.
Yeah, not to the metropolitan area, the hub.
I'll tell you what, you know, the last time I was there, I went to a really great Mexican restaurant.
Oh, well.
With real Mexican thrown in it, so it was really good. Anyway, yeah, so that is the fourth annual Little Manatee Jam at Canoe Outpost on the Little Manatee River. And the actual address is 18001 US 301 South in Waimea. And you can camp there too if you want, but I'll tell you what, if you want more information about that, you can go to WMNF.org. I know there's going to be a bunch of bands there. Have Gun Will Travel, The Dead Fields, Come Back Alice, one of our new favorite bands, Wild Adriatic, and of course Rebekah and the Reluctant Prophets, Dr. Mark Ed Carter. It's all happening tomorrow, starting at 2 p.m., about the time.
Yeah.
What do you know when you're going to be on?
It's either 4:30 or 5:30.
Okay. Well.
5:40.
Okay.
That's what time it is.
Do us another tune.
Okay. Oh, yeah, that's good. I should. Sometimes it's better when I don't talk a lot. This time.
People have said that about all of us. Yeah.
Well, that's just rude.
I resemble that.
It might be true. Though. So this one's called Sweet Life, and it's a little bit different version than on the CD that I put it on. The CD I played the piano on. It's real pretty, bass and upright bass with some fiddle playing by. Wonderful musician in the area called Rebekah Zapin, named Rebekah Zapin.
Oh, she's great. Yeah.
Yeah. So this is a little different version, but when I play it on the guitar, I like to do it like this. So. I go away.
Rebekah Pulley, I guess, on today's Live Music Showcase. What's that song about?
I think it's just sort of about life in general, about, you know, living and trying to enjoy it and try not to think about dying too much. Because sometimes you think about that as you get older.
You're talking about pushing to the limit, so I mean, what's...
Well, it's, you know, I don't know. I've had kind of a rough life, not as tough as some people, but I've had a pretty rough and tumble life, so I think I've pushed myself to many limits, and I found sometimes when you think you just can't, you're like, I can't do one more second of this. Just, I don't know. There's something comes from somewhere, some strength or something, and you're just able to keep doing it, so, you know. It applies to a lot of stuff, work, life, love, family, kids, just about anything.
You got kids.
Yeah.
You got family.
I have all those things.
So, but I'm just wondering, you know, when, what prompted you to write the song? One little incident or something like that?
I wish I knew where songs specifically came from, because then I could on demand write them.
You mean you go to that place where they are, where they're hanging out,
right?
Grab one.
Exactly.
Out of the ether.
I'm not necessarily, I think I write a lot of songs from maybe emotional places. I'm not a good verbal communicator, like I know women are supposed to be. I'm much better at writing things down, thoughts, ideas, you know, and turning those into a song. And I get my point across better when I sing. That's why I'm not very good at telling stories. I kind of stumble over a lot of my words.
So we'll just let you sing for the rest of the day.
So
that's okay.
Yeah, but actually, that song specifically was originally called Sweet Wine Blues. I will say that. And I was just bored at home one night by myself and opened a bottle of wine and was sitting there playing my guitar. And so originally the song was Pour Me Some Sweet Wine and Give Me Love to Break My Heart, blah, blah. And I was singing it to a friend of mine for the first time, and apparently I wasn't pronunciating very well, and they thought I was saying sweet life, pour me some sweet life.
So, hey, wait a minute,
and I was
that's
like,
good.
And I was like, yeah, I was like, that's actually a lot better. And so I kept it. So, yeah.
What's his next one?
That's a good question. I think maybe I'll try something like... maybe something that we would play tomorrow in the band. And it's really interesting to hear how different, it's interesting to hear how different a song sounds acoustically as opposed to with the band.
So the band will be there tomorrow afternoon, touring the band.
Yeah, they will be.
Who's in the band now?
Rob Pastore has been playing with me for, almost 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
He plays upright bass when he's with the band. He also is a really great pedal steel guitar player. And when him and I do a duo show, he brings both of those instruments and alternates. But tomorrow he'll just be playing the upright bass with the band. There is a really great guitar player that's been playing with us for about 4 or 5 years now. His name is S.G. Wood. He's fantastic. And then we have a sit-in drummer who has played a show or two with us, and he's amazing. His name is Joe Martin, because our drummer for the last 6 years or so, Max Norton, he hightailed it out of here. First chance he took, man, he took off on us. First chance he got for a shot at something.
A shot at the big time?
Yeah, and I can't knock him for it. I'm actually really happy for him. So, yeah, so we're kind of in between drummers, but Joe's working out. I don't know, might work. So
you can hear it all tomorrow afternoon. What's this next one going to be?
Yeah, I'm going to play a song called Sister Sally. So, and I could say this one, it's not about incest. I say sister and brother and a lot as they pertains to a loving, intimate relationship, but when I grew up, you know, all the adults were brother and sister so and so, so I just assumed that that's what you called people, as opposed to Mr. or Mrs. So I just wanted. Well, you know that. I guess a Southern, maybe slightly religious thing.
Sister Sally shakes like a sail without a tree. The long hair flowing right down to her knees. Brother John, he gets everything he needs. There's two strong hands and a steady strolling. Sister Sally's side, so close to the one.